Good morning and happy Easter to everyone joining us on our online Easter service of East Union Mennonite Church. It seems that this morning is bathed in sunlight and the green grass is showing and just a beautiful morning and a beautiful morning to worship together. Sounds like locally spring showers may be coming this afternoon, but we'll deal with that when the time comes. I continue to be astounded at seeing the new faces and the people from around the country and around the globe that are coming together to worship in this online form of worship. And it makes my heart full and joy. Joy comes to my heart to see so many familiar faces. And I wish, we're going to be normal again we're going to gather again in the sanctuary sometime, but I would just like this Zoom form to go on a little bit longer. But whether you're watching from near or far, remember a guest, know that it is indeed a good day to worship together, and all are welcome to celebrate this Easter day, the resurrection of our Lord Jesus Christ. This Easter service and day will be full of hope, love, music, and joy. A day full of life and light to let everyone shout and proclaim, the Lord is risen. The Lord is risen indeed. Hallelujah. This morning's announcements, we want to remind that all announcements and the current bulletin are available online. If you have an announcement, please email or contact Crystal at East Union or EU Cares at the church office or either by email or phone. Another announcement is that a reminder that Poverty Inc. Video and discussion, the documentary, will be available on a Zoom format this coming Wednesday night at 6:30 p.m. Anyone interested in editing services, videos, songs, or slides, please contact Joel Beachy. It's a wonderful way to learn how to do this. I can tell you that from experience.
Training is available if you're interested.
So absolutely.
Feel free to show interest.
And once again, send any announcements to eucares@kctc.net. Throughout the time of Lent, candles in the sanctuary and on the worship table were extinguished to symbolize the light of Jesus' life drawing to a close and the world getting darker. But today, we light all the candles to symbolize Christ's resurrection, a love that is stronger than death and gives every one of us life anew. We will now have a congregational song, Low in the Grave He Lay, the accompaniment by Bruce Harvey. Thank you. Please join me in the call to worship. I will read the leader. Emily, please join Emily with the people reading. The Lord is risen.
The Lord is risen indeed.
Let all the people of East Union declare.
The Lord is risen indeed.
Let all the earth declare.
The Lord is risen indeed.
Hallelujah. Our affirmation of faith. Since we have been raised to new life with Christ, we set our sights on the realities of heaven, where Christ sits in the place of honor at God's right hand. We think about the things of heaven. We too have died to the things of this earth, and our real life is hidden with Christ in God. And when Christ, who is our life, is revealed to the whole world, we will share in all his glory. Thanks be to God. We'll now have another congregational song. Lift your glad voices.
Lift your glad voices in triumph on high, for Jesus hath risen and man shall not die. Vain were the terrors that gathered around him and short the burst from the fetters of darkness that bound him, resplendent in glory to live and to save. Loud was the chorus of angels on high, the Savior hath risen and man shall not die. Glory to God.
Being able to gather together, that we ask everyone to check out the online giving option for East Union or mail your offering to East Union Mennonite Church. Please join me in a prayer of offering. God of grace, we hear your call to generous giving in the way you meet our needs each day and the peace you give which passes understanding. Having received so much, we offer all we have. We offer our time. We offer our talents and money for your kingdom. Lord, bless these gifts for the work of your church. In your name we pray, amen. We'll now have another song. In the bulb, there is a flower.
Oh,
wonderful, what a wonderful song. And now, kids, it's your time. Come forward, not too close, but come closer and pay attention because it's children's time. And what a treat we have for you. You thought we couldn't get any better than Wilmer and Barbie. Well, I'm going to tell you, this day is, we got a production that is beyond reproach. It tells the story of Mary, of the tomb, the
Oh, you should just let them tell.
Okay, all right, that's good. Just enjoy, because it's brilliant. All right, this little light of mine, I'm going to let it shine. This little light of mine, I'm going to let it shine. This little light of mine, I'm going to let it shine. Let it shine, let it shine, let it shine.
Take it away, Christine and the guys.
Mary Magdalene, Joanna, Mary the mother of James, and some other women got up while it was still dark. They carried their spices toward the tomb. The women were on their way to anoint the body of their dear friend Jesus. They said to one another, "Who will roll away the stone for us from the entrance to the tomb?" But when they got to the tomb, they found the stone rolled away. They did not find Jesus's body. Suddenly, a figure in dazzling clothes stood beside them. The women were terrified and bowed their faces to the ground. The bright figure said, "Do not be afraid. You are looking for Jesus of Nazareth, who was crucified. He has been raised. He is not here." The women ran to tell Jesus' other friends. The disciples didn't believe it. It seemed like a made-up story. Peter got up and ran to the tomb. The stone was rolled away. He stooped and looked inside the tomb. Sure enough, there were the linen cloths that Jesus' body had been wrapped in. But Jesus' body was not there. Peter went back home amazed at what had happened.
We'll now have a time of signs of hope. We've asked everyone to send in photos, and you have responded. There are so many wonderful images and signs that we've seen and received, and it's time for us to share them now to everyone else. So we'll have the signs of hope, and it'll be followed by a pre-recorded sermon by Pastor Joel. We want to thank Nora and Sarah Yoder for producing the following video, and now this week's signs of hope.
I believe in the risen one. I believe I overcome.
such so aimless, life filled with sin. I wouldn't let my dear Savior in. Then Jesus came like an angel in the night. Praise the Lord, I saw the light. I saw the light, I saw the light. No more darkness, no more night. Now I'm so happy, no sorrow inside. Blind man, I wandered alone. Wearies and fears I claimed for my own. Then like the blind man that God gave back his sight. Praise the Lord, I saw the light. I saw the light, I saw the light. No more darkness, no more night. Now I'm so happy, no sorrow inside. Praise.
Good morning. It is so good to be worshiping with you this morning. Christ is risen. He is risen indeed. The day has come. This is the day that the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad in it. I want to encourage you this morning, even if you do not personally feel like rejoicing today, I want to let you know that that is okay. But I also want to say that it is a day for rejoicing. What was lost has been found. What was broken has been restored. What was dead has new life. Our Savior is risen, and the stone has been rolled away from the tomb. Glory be to God. The psalmist reminds us today how much we have to be thankful for. I invite you to listen to the words of the psalmist in Psalm 118, verses 1 to 2 and 14 to 24. Oh, give thanks to the Lord, for he is good. His steadfast love endures forever. Let Israel say, his steadfast love endures forever. The Lord is my strength and my might. He has become my salvation. There are glad songs of victory in the tents of the righteous. The right hand of the God of the Lord does valiantly. The right hand of the Lord is exalted. The right hand of the Lord does valiantly. I shall not die, but I shall live and recount the deeds of the Lord. The Lord has punished me severely, but he did not give me over to death. Open to me the gates of righteousness, that I may enter through them and give thanks to the Lord. The stone that the builders rejected has become the chief cornerstone. This is the Lord's doing. It is marvelous in our eyes. This is the day that the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad in it. I can't read verse 24 of Psalm 118 without hearing the kids' praise song blasting in my ears, "This is the day that the Lord has made." So I thought I'd share a version that I found that I really enjoyed.
This is the day.
If you recall, we actually read Psalm 118 on Palm Sunday too. This repeat of Psalm 118 can create sort of a bridge for us to rejoice both at the triumphal entry and now at the other side of the tomb. We shout Hosanna, not just for Jesus' arrival, but for Jesus' victory over death and our thanksgiving for God's gift of salvation. But how do we capture the essence of this good news? We are so underwhelmed by good news these days. If it's not the biggest, the strongest, the loudest, the newest, the shiniest, most expensive, unique, and surprising, whatever it is, we are apt to think that it's not amazing. So how do we react to the good news of Jesus' miraculous triumph over death? How do we not hear this good word and simply move on to the next part of our day? Maybe it is easier in the time of the coronavirus. We recognize the disruption to our lives, and so many of us are forced to look inwards at what really gives meaning to not only the arc of our lives, but our daily rituals and routines. On the other hand, maybe the coronavirus makes it harder. We are consumed with worry or guilt or fear of the unknowns. Regardless, I am here to tell you this morning that Jesus has risen, and it is amazing. One way we are reminded about what is amazing is through the arts. E.E. Cummings was an author, poet, artist who died in 1962. During World War I, he served and was reportedly imprisoned in a French prison camp for 3 months on the suspicion of treason. Well, after his release in early 1918, Cummings, among other poems, he wrote, "I thank you, God, for most this amazing day." His experience of war, scarcity, death, and imprisonment created a context for simple gratitude, seeing the trees and sky. This poem echoes the cries of Jesus and of his disciples. "I who have died am alive again today." So I want to share this poem and a piece of Cummings' artwork entitled Chocorua Landscape. I thank you, God, for most this amazing day. I thank you, God, for most this amazing day, for the leaping greenly spirits of trees and a blue true dream of sky, and for everything which is natural, which is infinite, which is yes. I who have died am alive again today, and this is the sun's birthday. This is the birthday of life and of love and wings and of the gay, great happening, illimitably earth. How should tasting, touching, hearing, seeing, breathing any, lifted from the know of all nothing, human merely being, doubt, unimaginable you? Now the ears of my ears awake, and now the eyes of my eyes are opened. Our eyes and ears are open today, much as the eyes and ears of the women at the tomb and of Peter and John racing to the tomb were opened. You see, if we are not amazed at Jesus' resurrection, we should be. The disciples surely were. Why else would the women's report be received in such disbelief? Not only did they not get that Jesus was going to die, but they were definitely confounded when he was executed by the Romans on the cross. And we should be confounded too. It doesn't make sense. Yet Jesus is able to overcome death, even this excruciating and humiliating death on the cross as a common criminal. Jesus continued to amaze those around him throughout the Gospels. If we look at the ministry and his life, we see that this is a common refrain. I'm going to give you some examples from the Synoptic Gospels now. So when we think about this amazement, we can think about when Jesus calmed the storm after the disciples got over being afraid. They were amazed and they asked, "What sort of man is this?" in Matthew 8. When Jesus forgave sins, they were all amazed in Mark 2 and Luke 5. When Jesus drove the demonic spirit out of a man, the crowds were amazed, and never before had anything like this been seen in Matthew 9. When Jesus cured someone blind and mute, all the crowds were amazed. "Can this be the son of David?" Matthew 12. When the lame, the maimed, the blind, the mute, and many others were put at his feet and cured, the crowd was amazed when they saw the mute speaking, the maimed whole, the lame walking, and the blind seeing, and they praised the God of Israel in Matthew 15. And when Jesus refused to answer the charges against him, Pilate, it is written, was greatly amazed in Matthew 27. And Peter, seeing the empty grave clothes in Jesus' tomb, he was amazed at what had happened in Luke 24. It is amazing. Jesus is alive. Hallelujah. Even amid the coronavirus, there can be new life. Stories of people sharing of their resources with those who do not have enough. Prayers and artwork and music that demonstrate God's surpassing beauty through creation in God's people. It's all amazing. May we be amazed yet again this Easter at God's saving work through the resurrection of Jesus. May we be in awe that the tomb is empty. May it be so. Christ is risen. He is risen indeed.
Amen, Joel. Amen. A ritual response today. Joel had asked you to have a piece of paper and a writing utensil handy. With those, we'd like you to pause and reflect and write down one place you want to see God's resurrection love and power over death in your life. It might be something that feels like it has died in your life, or a place of conflict in the world, or a relationship that seems to have died. Bruce will be playing "Oh, Hail the Power of Jesus' Name," two verses on the piano, and during that time, take some time and write that down. After you're finished, tuck the piece of paper into your Bible or a place that you can come across it routinely, noticing how God's power is alive in this concern and how God's love is bringing healing. Thank you.
So at this time, we it's been a tradition at East Union to celebrate with on Easter with the Hallelujah Chorus. And we want to send a special thank you again to Sarah Yoder for putting together this video. To close with our benediction, go in the joy of Jesus's resurrection to spread the good news that death is not the end, that God's love is the power we can lean into, and that the cross has been forever transformed into the assurance of eternity with our Lord. Go in peace.